This movement in this country promised women once that they could have it all, a successful career, financial success, and a family. But now, a controversial new study by the University of Pennsylvania suggests that women are less happy than men, despite all of the progress that women have made since the 1970s. Inez Foray has our report.
Reading stories about 5-10 years ago, these women who were trailblazers in the late 60s, early 70s, a few years ago, they're getting into their 50s and 60s, and they start saying, geez, I should have had kids. I should have had a family. What if I missed? Not everybody said that, of course, but there seems to be this back and forth, this eternal struggle, even with these women who were trailblazers, who were feminists, who did things that changed the workforce. Where are we now?
The recession's reshaping the country in a lot of ways, really. It's changed how we do business and who does that business. Women are closing the gap with men in the workforce, and if things continue the way they are right now, women could soon make history by making up the majority of Americans bringing home paychecks.
Huge milestone. Women now make up more than 47% of the American workforce, a number that will continue to grow as male-dominated industries are reduced.
We've seen more.
Slate.com profiled a former office manager and University of California grad, I'm one of those, who after 5 months of unemployment turned to online prostitution, like me, and has since turned a steady, albeit sticky, profit.
Ew.
Escort managers and strip clubs have reported an increase in job applications over the past 7 months, and says an X-rated video chat producer, quote, now we're seeing performers who are more educated and used to working on a regular schedule. Mm-hmm. There's been a shift to a very different class of people. You know, I think we have tape of some of those performers here.
16 and 17-year-olds taking off their clothes for money. Right now, minors in the state can legally dance at gentlemen's clubs, but tonight there's a push to close that loophole.
At this moment, at least, is Kimberly, and she's flown into town to take a job as a prostitute at one of the few places in America where it's legal. The self.
Crazy. I'm crazy for feeling so lonely.
Booker.
I'm crazy, crazy for feeling so
lonely. Oh my.
Alexandra Dupre in a 2003 Girls Gone Wild spring break production. Girls Gone Wild founder Joe Francis says Ashley posed for the video while in Miami celebrating her 18th.
Thank you.
come a long way, baby.
Women have come a long way in the last 35 years, but despite a movement that brought so much progress to American women, their happiness has dropped relative to men over the last three decades.
The reason we find that surprising is that if you look across society, there's been a lot of social change that shifted things towards women.
The data was studied.
We've never had more choices as women, and yet I see young women paralyzed because there are so many choices. And there's research that shows us the more choices you have, the more it kind of freezes you. And what they worry about is making a choice they're going to regret. Mm-hmm. And you only have a certain amount of time to make those choices because we know the fertility issue. Young women have what we call fertility freak out now because they've seen women in their mid to late 30s struggle with that. So they've got to pack it all in yeah. in a short time.
Positive about your figure or negative?
Good days and bad days.
Nearly half of the women who participated in the AP iVillage poll say they have negative feelings about their figures. Not surprising to ...53% of the women polled said they have negative feelings about their weight. 57% described themselves as overweight. 24% were on a diet. But only 8% eat the recommended 5 daily servings of fruits and vegetables.
And talk about salaries as well. But they bring them in young, and then they fall because they're way too young for what they're doing. And I turned down several jobs along the way at CBS because I wasn't ready for them. But here we were being propped up. So there's a lot of that.
Reading stories about 5-10 years ago, these women who were trailblazers in the late 60s, early 70s, you know, a few years ago, they're getting into their 50s and 60s, and they start saying, geez, I should have had kids. I should have had a family. What if I missed? Not everybody said that, of course, but there seems to be this back and forth, this eternal struggle, even with these women who were trailblazers, who were feminists, who did things that changed the workforce. Where are we now?